topic, dream, explore, and inspire. One thing that's always confused me is, what do I want to become? Everyone's kept asking, I never had an answer for. As a six-year-old kid, for whom endings were never sad, I wished I became a princess with magical powers in hand. As I stepped into it and realized I could speak well, I planned out the whole journey as an actress then and there. On being a 10-year-old, singing seemed to be the best career, just have to impress the audience, which seemed like no barrier. At 12, I had decided I want to become a doctor, a profession so noble and kind will earn all I can ask for. And then at 14 and 15, I wondered, was it needed to know in advance what I'd become? I'm not a tarot card reader. But then 16 came too early to decide what to chase, arts or commerce, science or humanity. I got stuck in the maze. But be sure about one thing. I will do something worldwide in the path of life ahead of me, learning with every mind. Dream as much as you can. Aspirations need not be few. As a princess turned into a doctor, who knows what life has for you? The point I am trying to prove here is that dreams are never, should never be quantified, they should never be counted. I mean, I wrote this poem when I was in class 11th. The plan was still, I didn't know I'd be standing here today addressing some of the best minds in the country. So it's very important that we keep dreaming with eyes closed open. And back then, dreaming was something about what I'd become, how much will I earn, what would be my profession. But let's face it, dreams don't have to be all about aspirations. Dreams can inspire awe in you. Dreams can make you wonder. Dreams can even make you blush, right? So one thing that comes to my mind is, are dreams useful at all? I'd say heck yes. Because dreams help you explore. Dreams let you go out there and look at all the options which you thought were illogical, all the options which you thought are lacking the profit. Blame our minds or blame our education, we all think in terms of numbers. But dreams let you go beyond them and think more, aspire more. We always tend to tell people that the idea you're telling me is, this is illogical, but trust me, if your dream is not illogical, if the feeling, that feeling of wind on your face, if that doesn't remind you of your dream, you're doing something wrong. Because all great leaders have had some pinch of insanity in their ideas. They were always dreaming with their eyes open. And yet, we unknowingly stop ourselves. We kind of barricade ourselves from dreaming, and that is where we're going wrong. When I talk about exploring, how can one explore? I think exploring can be done in many ways. Traveling is one of the best ways, in fact. When you travel, you go out there, meet new people, learn about cultures, and traveling is almost therapeutic because it makes you feel small, it makes you feel very humble, it makes you realize that what a small person you are in this big entire world. It's not necessary to actually go physically out there. I think reading is another way of exploring. And when I come to reading, we read so many authors, it's almost as if we are talking to such great minds. We are getting to know their ideas. I'm sure all of us have read some paragraph and kind of closed the book, thought about it, read that again, and just sat there in awe of how did she or he think of this. So I think it's very important that we get to know all perspectives, when even in this